I've done the white one, and I decided not to glare it anymore because of the fade. But then I decided to do, I wanted to do a mural here all along, so I started with this building, and that's a paint pen, except for the windows, but the main structure is a paint pen, and it's pretty durable. Then I put the tree in and the clouds, and by the way, that's Mary Poppins coming down in the sky. And then, of course, it's a hansom cab, and then I decided I should have a stairs to get to the lower level, because the train track is actually a paint rail that Chrysler puts on the car, so I use it as a train track. And the theme of this picture was for the Flying Scotsman. This is the Flying Scotsman. It's probably the most famous steam train in the world, and I've been aboard it when I was in the UK. And then I actually have this in HO, so I actually copied it, so it's very close to HO scale. This building was the first building because I got tired of putting so many rail cars. They're very tedious to do. And I also thought I should have a building in front of the train every now and then. And so I did this, and I'm not sure if this is going to be, at first it was going to be a train station, and I thought it could be a post office, but it might become a Willy Wonka candy store. I haven't decided yet. So that's it. And then I decided to put these background buildings in later, just to make it look more like a cityscape, like a castle back here that goes to there. And then I have a church in the background. This is supposed to be a railroad-related building. And then this is just like, this is the Cratchit house. And I made them look really poor by putting the roots all over the house and even having the water almost come up to their front door. And of course, this would be a river that the locomotive's going over. And then just another English building, but I thought a thatched roof would be kind of cute. And again, to fill in the space, I put trees. Those trees are way too tall for anything in England. And obviously, I put this building in where I can make it taller. And then this would be, I guess you would say, it's just from fantasy, but it's a kind of like a Tudor-style Victorian mansion, I guess, because it's a kind of a combination. It's got the gingerbread, but it's really mostly Victorian. And when I started in this section, you can see I was still wide awake. And then all of a sudden I realized I'm getting dizzy looking at this thing doing this, and I did it more sloppily. And I can correct some of that, but it's going to have to be done. But what I really, then I realized I should do a Christmas carol. So, as I say, that was the Cratchit house. Here's Ebenezer Scrooge's house. I boarded up the lower windows, kind of made it look a little run down so that, you know, he's a humbug and all that. So Tiny Tim and Bob Cratchit are walking by, and then Scrooge and the Ghost of Christmas Past are going out the side window. That's the Ghost of Christmas Future. And then this is the Ghost of, Present. And then this is the Ghost of Christmas Future. And if you told me 3 weeks ago I was going to put a cemetery on my car, I'd say no way. But once you do the Christmas Carol, you got to have a cemetery. And it's kind of perfect in this part of the car because it's a little less room for buildings. So I did, and it's already needing to be restored, some of it. But I did, I even put the lightning. I've had to do lightning like 3 times now, and the clouds I do almost once a week. They just need to be kept up. You know, the sun gets to them. And then these are just miscellaneous English buildings, you know, either houses or businesses. And again, I like the Tudor style of different styles of Tudor style buildings. And this is Marley with all the chains going through, you know, in his afterlife. And there's Marley's grave right near Ebenezer Scrooge's grave. So I just thought, and then I put Tiny Tim's grave, if you remember, but then I said, and Tiny Tim did not die because obviously Scrooge changed his ways. But now getting back down to the white picture, the castle in this village was based on Cardiff, Wales, and Yorkshire. The city of York is, it's kind of, I got some of my inspiration from the Shambles and from Cardiff, Wales. And then obviously the, oh, and this is a, it's not Stonehenge, but there are a lot of old pagan circles in England. So it was just a simple thing to put on top of the tire because it's usually high ground. Windmills are everywhere in Europe, so I had to do that. And then, of course, I wanted to. And then, of course, this is Yosemite Valley with the church, which is the most historic building in Yosemite. And then this is the Sierra Club building. And, of course, they, you know, inspired the national park idea. And then, of course, Camp Curry. They were the first original concessionaire of Yosemite. And then that's the Merced River. I had to make the river into a waterfall on the car because of where I put it on the door seam. And then I haven't finished Half Dome, but that's Half Dome and El Capitan here. And then some of the background mountains that are kind of should look. I did most of this from memory. And then I connected this picture with the high country going through here. And then these are the rocks at White Wolf in Yosemite. And then this is the Indian village, or a traditional Indian village, and I kind of wish I put it in a better location, but that was supposed to be Yosemite Falls, but I didn't have enough room to put it in its full grandeur on the car. And then, of course, the castle's all wire. I did it kind of more from the World's Fair of Expo 86, a little bit of inspiration from It's a Small World. Also, I wanted it to be light and airy and thought it would be very light on the roof. It's about 600 pounds. So it's not light and airy. Yeah, occasionally. Most of them like it. Some of them don't. There's always... You know, that's usually what they like to give me a ticket for, is obstructed view. So you just never know. You know what I mean? The police can... Most of them do enjoy it, but there's always one or two that want to be a jerk about it.